Welcome, everybody. Today we're going to be playing Star Wars Battlefront. This is, of course, the classic, not the EA version, DICE version that people don't like. This is from 2004. This is Pandemic's version. I would argue the best version. I'm sure there's a lot of people who agree. But let me jump into the battle just so that things don't get too out of control here. So as you guys know, it's been almost a year since I've uploaded a video. And the reason for that is, number one, I wanted to take a break from YouTube, and kind of just get my bearings, in terms of school and work and just in my life in general. And I felt that YouTube, needed to be put on the back burner for a little bit. However, now I'm going to be working on reviews for games, or critiques, maybe a better word for it. And that includes games like Star Wars Battlefront. I got absolutely destroyed there. That's why I shouldn't fly. And I felt that the best way to do this, of course, is going to be a highly edited, highly scripted video. And if you look at my last video, you'll see what I'm talking about. It talks about Sir Awesome's Hall of Greats or whatever. Honestly, I don't know if I'm going to call it that anymore. I feel that that's kind of cheesy, personally. I don't know what I'll call it, but I'll figure it out by the time, of course, the videos come out. However, what I will say is that I obviously need gameplay for that. And I decided that maybe a good thing to do would be show you my gameplay as in video form like I normally do. My old videos, and then at the end have a very highly edited review. So basically, I'm getting footage right now, and that's going to be me playing through every map in Battlefront, kind of just getting an idea of what's going on, because that's important. I want to fully review this game. Today I'm going to do every map, and in the next days I'm going to do, you know, Galactic Conquest, the single player, and of course, you know, multiplayer if possible. I'm pretty sure servers are up for it, at least fan-made servers. I'll try and get into multiplayer, although the good news is the multiplayer is not different really at all from the single player, so it's not like major if I can't get into multiplayer. However, whether I upload every part kind of just depends. I don't think, you know, every part of this game is going to be interesting. I think there will be some cool moments that y'all can see in videos. Kind of chill videos where I kind of just talk and battle it out with the Empire in this case, or whoever else I'm fighting in the other levels. So, what I will say is that I'm excited to do review type videos. I've never done anything that edited for this channel. Usually mine's pretty, you know, not edited, pretty raw gameplay and commentary. There's not much trickery going on, there's not much research that goes into it, but I really want to try and put my best foot forward with these videos. Whoa, I'm alive. Okay, that's weird. And that includes doing research, finding articles, looking at reviews from 2004 in this case. That's when this game came out. And just getting an understanding of how this game was received then, and reflecting on how I received it when I was a kid, and kind of looking at it through a modern lens. And one thing I do want to touch on while I'm on the topic of that is inevitably... when this video releases, and, you know, when the big Battlefront video releases, there's going to be a lot of talk about the EA DICE Battlefront games. And people, you know, are naturally going to compare it, which I think is important to do. I think sometimes, especially now in the state that the gaming industry is in, I think it's important to see how far we've come, but also how far we've regressed in some ways. And Battlefront provides a perfect example of that. You're not going to hear me rant about Battlefront 2, the infamous Battlefront 2, of course. or EA's Battlefront 2015. I don't plan on doing that. The only one I've really truly played is the first Battlefront that was released by EA and DICE. And my impressions were it was a very hollow and soulless game. The shooting mechanics were, you know, it was a solid shooter, but it was just, like I said, soulless. And I think that that pretty much echoes the sentiments of most of the online community, if not all. Battlefront 2, however, I only played the open beta of that. I personally did not purchase it or play it on anything else. I figured, you know, oh, this is good, you know, from what I played in the open beta. But it was, you know, it was okay. You know, I liked it. I was like, oh, okay, cool Star Wars shooter. They made it a little bit more deep. But I didn't, you know, get to experience firsthand the horrors of the star card system or the loot crates or surprise mechanics, whatever EA calls them now. So, I'm not going to be doing a comparison video between those games. I will, however, in time, do a Star Wars Battlefront 2, the pandemic one, the sequel to this one that everybody loves. I will be doing comparison between this game and that game, but that will be coming with that video, so that, of course, will be pending as well. But in terms of game right now, a little bit more, less meta-focused, so to speak, I've been really enjoying my time, and if you're wondering how you can pick this up, this is on Steam, of course. I'm pretty sure it's backwards compatible on the Xbox, but don't quote me on that. However, I've been playing it on PC. I mean, it's pretty easy to run now. And as you can see, you're able to run it at 1080p, which is what my monitor's at. I don't know how high you can go exactly. If I go to options here, maybe I can show you guys. I think this is something I have to do in the menu. And unfortunately, the menu kind of bugs out my recording software. So, unfortunately, I won't be able to show you that. But it goes up to 1080p, which is perfect for me. The FOV is a little bit restrictive, which is, you know, understandable and common in older video games. There is a modification that I've seen on the Steam discussions, but I have just not gotten around to downloading it. And honestly, the FOV is not that bad, especially when you're in third person. First person's a little bit constrictive, but for some reason it just works, to quote Todd Howard. You know, it's just, it's got a good mix of FOV. I don't know exactly what the value is. I would say it's maybe in the 60s, but I could be completely wrong. But it just feels right. You know, it doesn't feel like I'm going to be motion sick like other games. And I'm sitting, you know, maybe not even more than a foot from my computer screen. So, it's also amazing to just look at this, and I'm glad that this started out. This is a kind of an introduction, because you get to see all of the spaceships just duking it out with each other while there's a huge, obviously, raging fight in the middle. And this is personally why I prefer, at least in nostalgic terms, but maybe even in gameplay mechanic terms, Battlefront 1 to Battlefront 2. As great as Battlefront 2 is, I mean, it's a wonderful game. It doesn't have, at least that I remember, so I could be wrong on this, but it doesn't have the level of combined arms that this game has, because there were no space battles in this game. Which, yeah, is definitely a drawback. But I also enjoy seeing an X-Wing and TIE Fighter fly over me and duke it out, even though within the Star Wars universe it may not make sense. It gives that battlefield feel, which is definitely what this game was trying to emulate, and did so, I would say, pretty successfully. It's definitely a good chaotic combined arms game. It's kind of a more simple, although by today's standards, Battlefield 1942 is very simple. Kind of a simple battlefield. It's kind of like this, and this isn't by no means to be degrading to the series, but it's almost like baby's first Battlefield. At least it was for me, because I was very young when this game came out. And I remember picking this up, or my parents picking it up for me, on the PlayStation 2, which I would argue is one of, if not the greatest console of all time. But, you know, that's for another day. But anyways, I just thought it was amazing. And I was like, whoa, because I've always, you know, I've been a Star Wars fan, but I've never been like super, super into it, you know, like other people. I was always kind of just of the, oh, you know what, we're going to change teams here. We'll mix things up. I was always of the opinion that, oh, Star Wars is really cool. And that's about it. You know, the Jedi are cool and everything, but I always thought the Stormtroopers and the Rebels were really kind of the cool guys, the kind of the unsung heroes, you know, type feel. And honestly, if I look back at the pattern of games that I played in the last, you know, 20 years of my life, that's been a common narrative in a lot of the shooters, especially that I've enjoyed, is kind of the idea of playing as, you know, the faceless, unsung hero, the forgotten soldier, or whatever you want to call it. Or them. I always, I was about to shoot that guy. I was used to shooting Imperials. I always enjoy that aspect, and I think that one of the first games that I can remember that really kind of pushed that was Call of Duty. I mean, that puts you in the boots of not a nameless soldier, but definitely a faceless one who had to work together with his allies, or friend, what am I, squad mates, that was hard to find, squad mates, to complete an objective, and it isn't a bombastic objective. Now, there's certainly bombastic missions in Call of Duty, especially today, but I mean classic Call of Duty. For some reason, I cannot go down this ledge. Is this a bug? That is weird. I'll have to remember that when I'm making the review. We're going to find this again. Hold on, guys. I don't mean to get off my train of thought, but that's just weird. It was over here. Now, one thing that I will keep in mind, of course, and I have to keep in mind, is that, I literally can't get over this. I have to jump over it. That's weird. I have to do a little bit of bug research. Because this may be, for all I know, a bug to the Steam version that was released this year, you know? So, I don't want to nail a game for a version, you know? I want to try and keep the bug report as close to, its original release as possible, which will be difficult to do for a lot of these games, because, obviously, the way that I'm playing a lot of these games is through either re-releases, or in the case of PlayStation 2 games, emulators. I have a PlayStation 2, but to record it and to, you know, kind of just make it more manageable, I emulate it on my PC. Although I could do some research and try and record it old school, but that's going to take a lot of time and money, and I just don't really know if that's what I want to do in the long run. But what I'm trying to say is, I'm going to have to be careful when it comes to performance, because I need to kind of stack and realize the odds for each system and release or whatever. That's why I'm going to be kind of lenient on performance. But anyways, back to the whole Forgotten Soldier thing. Medal of Honor kind of gives you that vibe, but it's really almost like GoldenEye in World War II. You're a very special soldier. You are part of the OSS, which, if you don't know, is kind of the predecessor to the CIA. So you are deep, deep within Allied intelligence. You are the bee's knees when it comes to special operations. I mean, you're blowing up U-boats and rockets and trains and stuff like that. You know, there are a few elements of the missions where, you know, you do large battles like D-Day and stuff. But for the most part, this is not a good place to be. It is pretty spectacular, I guess is the word I'm looking for. But Battlefront doesn't really give you that feeling. There are heroes in the game. I don't know if I've turned them off or what, but you can't play as them in this Battlefront. They are just kind of assisted people who, you know, do a good job. And that's because, and you know, I don't think it may have been, but I don't think it's because they necessarily, you know, couldn't have you play as them because of the technology or whatever. Although it very well could be, because it seems like DICE has trouble with that. But I think it was more of something to do with they want you to be the stormtrooper who, you know, gets shot by Luke or Leia or whatever. They want you to be the rebel who gets, you know, sniped by, you know, an Imperial walker or whatever. You know, they want you to be the, you know, head in the crowd. And this makes for a very immersive Star Wars game. You feel like you are more part of the universe because you don't have that power fantasy to kind of distract you that a Jedi would give you, you know. And I'm not saying games that have Jedi aren't immersive, but at least for me, most of the time I'm sitting there thinking, okay, I'm a Jedi. But I never really think of the world because I always feel like it's such a fantastical position for me to be in the first place that my mind automatically wanders to being a Jedi with powers and, you know, the Force and lightsabers and everything else. But with a game like Battlefront where I'm just, it's basically a serial number for a name and I'm a stormtrooper or I'm a clone or a droid or just a rebel, you know, I just think, you know, if I was playing the Rebels right now, I'd thinking, oh, well, what if my guy's from Bespin? You know, what if he's from Cloud City? You know, what if this is, you know, his home that he's fighting over? You know, this stormtrooper right here, you know, what has his life looked like? How conditioned is he? Does he have any sympathies for the Rebels, or is he just convinced and locked in that these are enemies of the Empire and enemies to peace and order? You know, you can ask yourself questions like that. And it gives a lot more, funny enough, how ironic it may be in a game with aliens and everything else, but it makes you feel, it gives Star Wars a more of a humanity, you know, edge to it. It makes it feel more alive, and real and believable because it has these skirmishes that, while some of these battles are really major, a lot of these battles aren't seen in the movies. As far as I'm aware, there was not this big of a battle in Bespin. But it makes for a great map. You know, there's a lot of verticality here. Although it has, you know, what some may consider the weakness, but, you know, maybe more of balancing between maps. It doesn't have any vehicles, you know. But after what we just played, I think that gave us plenty of vehicle combat. Really interested by these hitboxes. They're pretty dang good. But yeah, so that is my commentary on Battlefront. That was a long-winded one. And those are by no means like my conclusions or anything. You know, I'm seeing its praises right now, but what if, you know, a few hours from now I get, you know, super, super tired of it, and I'm just like, oh, this game sucks, you know? So I will likely kind of go through a little bit of a roller coaster. But the good news about this game is it's not very hard to comprehend, and that's why I think it's a great place for me to start. It's not like an RPG where I have to think about writing and just, you know, game design and audio and voice acting. You know, Battlefront's a pretty stripped down game, and that's, you know, to its benefit in many cases, especially for someone like me who is just starting out doing critiques of games and just commentaries on games. I think Battlefront is kind of the perfect platform to launch off of. When I was, you know, thinking and bouncing around ideas in my head, of course I know what games I want to do, but it's a matter of, well, what will I do first? And I was stupid enough to try and do Arma 3 first. And any of you who've played it or watched Arma 3 know that that is a very, very complicated game, because not only do you have all the complicated features and, you know, elements of the actual vanilla game, but you also have the community aspect to it, which is arguably bigger than the game itself. And you have this whole question of simulator versus game, you know, realism versus sandbox. Why do people play it? Why do I play it? You know, so you don't really get that with Battlefront. I mean, why do I play this? I play this because I want to, you know, shoot Rebels or shoot Imperials or whatever and be in a cool Star Wars battle, you know. But with Arma, you know, it's a little bit more complicated, at least for me. And I think that's a late game type commentary once I have a little bit more of these below my belt. Under my belt. But anyways, I've probably rambled on long enough. I just wanted to give you guys a little bit of an idea of what's going on here at SirAwesomeMedia. It's not dead, you know. I mean, this has never been a channel that's been, like, pumping out videos anyways. I make videos when I feel like it, you know. This is still a hobby of mine. I enjoy it greatly. And the minute I don't is the minute that I won't make a video, because, I mean, who wants to watch that? I don't want to make it, and you wouldn't want to watch it. It's really a beautiful relationship. But I will say that I have enjoyed the years of SirAwesomeMedia. That's interesting that you can't shoot past a certain range. Like, look, they just don't even hit. I don't know how I feel about that. But I've definitely enjoyed the years of SirAwesomeMedia. It's amazing looking back and thinking, oh my god, you know, I've started out as like a, you know, 11, 12-year-old who had a crappy laptop mic and, you know, recorded, you know, Halo Custom Edition, which, you know, who plays that anymore? Although I would love to revisit it. You know, and this is Minecraft and everything. You know how it was. You know, you OGs. No. But it's been great. I would not have traded any experience for it in the world. I know that I've never had the most subscribers or viewers or anything. But regardless, you know, of how this ends or whatever, you know, the grand finale of SirAwesomeMedia, whenever or whatever that may be, probably not that dramatic. But I don't think I'll have any regrets, you know, whether this channel has, you know, 10 million subscribers or 10. As long as I enjoyed myself and the people enjoyed it along the way, then I think that you've made what's called a positive contribution to the community that is this world. So, sorry to get more a little philosophical there. In true SirAwesome fashion, I try and end the video and then say I'm going to end the video and then end it 10 minutes later because I guess I just really didn't want to end the video. But I hope you enjoyed this, guys. Let me know if you have any questions in the comments. I'll put my email down below if you have any questions or suggestions for games that I can try out. Real quickly, I'm going to go over the synopsis for what my series is, so if you have any suggestions or ideas. Or actually, you know what, I have a video that perfectly explains that. I'm not going to waste any more of your time, your guys' time. If you're really curious about what this series that I'm making is, check out my last video that came out almost a year ago. It's got Batman on it. It's got the new thumbnail design that I worked unholy amount of time on for something that really wasn't that impressive. But it's fresh, it's new, and I'm thinking about a new art style for the channel. And possibly just changing my channel name, but that will be discussed in a subsequent video later, where I talk more about what I want to do with this channel. But anyways, guys, I've been SirAwesome. I'm glad to have hosted you today for this Battlefront playthrough. I look forward to completing the review. I do not know when it'll be complete. I just don't know, you know, I have work and I have school will be starting soon and, of course, editing this and doing research, so I don't know when it will be complete, but when it is done, I promise that it will be the best Battlefront review that I can make, which hopefully will be at the very least entertaining for you guys, regardless of its quality. Anyways, have a great day, guys, and I will see you in the next video. Bye.